Okay, start off with an E. yeah, that's it.
The first question is, define music in your own words.
Music is an art form that allows artists for rap to express themselves.
Like any musician, it's like a way of expressing themselves.
I said music is like the kind of thing that made me happy.
My name is Jonathan Simon. I'm 19 years old. I go to Massasoit Community College and I'm into fitness.
My name is Nickerson Trelisi. I'm 20 years old and I'm a college student.
What's up my people? My name is Kelvin Bubble Noise, a young fresh, you know what I'm saying? I'm Nigerian, I'm 20 years old. I'm an Afrobeat artist, you know what I'm saying? I want y'all to support my music and listen to everything, you know what I'm saying? Get it popping, you know?
Music is an art form that allows artists to express themselves in a way that you couldn't do with writing, or that is not as easy with words, even though music is words, but through the melody and through the feeling of the song, it feels different.
Well, I think for rappers, or like any musician, it's like a way of expressing themselves. And yeah, it's a way of expressing themselves. It's like poems, like writing a novel, and the consumer, like us, we can like listen to the music or read the book to sort of relate to it. Yeah.
Nah, I'm gonna say my own word. Music is like, to me, my own self, you know what I'm saying? Not to everyone. My own self, I said music is like the kind of things that make me happy.
Well, the dictionary definition of music is a bunch of vocal and instrumental sounds put together to produce a form of harmony. But I think music is much more than that. Music is an art of expression. That's the best way I know how to define it. What first got you into music?
The first artist I started listening to was Russ. And he's a really good artist. The way he's able to make you feel through his words.
Not the chick I call it Lola. She feel like the ocean, like to drink and smoke some Doja, and I feel like smoking. Plus she good at charming cobras.
And through the music is really creative, and the fact that he does it all by himself is very inspirational. And he's all around just a great artist. Really got me into listening to more music.
I don't think it's one thing. I think it's just that music's always been part of my life as a kid. Because whenever there was like some sort of family gathering, there's always music involved. And I don't know, it's like, so when I was born in Haiti, music, I listen to music in Haiti. I like rap music.
Okay, this is what got me into music, right? Like I said, I'm Nigerian, so in my country, I've been trying to like, I'm a chorist in my country. I started making music, singing at the age of 11, but I wasn't into music fully like that. But I've been trying to get into the studio to make something. So there was a day I just sat down, like I was writing this shit, and I was like, damn, I think I could do this, you know what I'm saying?
When I came here, there wasn't like any, so the way I approached music remained the same. I didn't like say, oh damn, I don't like this music. I only like music I like. So it's the way that it crosses borders that, you know, even though different cultures, you can still enjoy the music from both without necessarily needing to know the language.
I go, yeah, based on everything, I go, yeah, and I feel like, yeah, I tell my people know what I'm made of and shit like that. I gotta let people know, yeah, I got talent in me. I wanna make something good. So now when I started writing this song and shit, I brought the title of the song with some of my boys, Neil Tito, Chris, Mustafa, shout out to my guys over there. So we all worked together, we wrote the song, we put it out, and it was dope. That's what got me into music. That's it.
Do you think music has gotten worse or better?
I for sure think music has gotten better through all the new artists that we've gotten. Like, I believe Polo G, all those new rappers who are bringing light to issues in their communities and all that stuff are doing positive.
I don't think it has gotten worse. No, it hasn't gotten better. I just think that it lacks substance. I sometimes listen to Playboi Carti, like some of his leaks, and I enjoy it. But when I'm listening to like someone like Kendrick or Vince Staples, I listen to it for different reasons. And one of the things that there's like a difference between musicians of today and musicians back then. The musicians we know back then, it's like the way they approached it, it meant more to them. So it wasn't just like, oh, a source of money or some shit like that. They were actually trying to go somewhere, you know, be like top five, top 10. But here it's just about, now it's just like, it's about getting money. Like, you just put the projects out, trying to get as much money as you can. Like, there's no substance.
I'm not gonna say go. Better like that. I'm not gonna say go worse, to be honest, because I feel like you got better because now we got young, like, we got new talent coming up in the music industry. You know what I'm saying? Every day by day, people be dropping songs. Every day, another artist coming up the way, another one coming up the way. I got like two other artists who work under me, and they're really good. So I feel like music is getting better, man. It was in the old days, if you be to be honest. Like, I'm not even gonna lie to you. It's getting really, really better, like, right now. Like, new artists dropping new songs. Like, you discover new talent every day, which is surprising. You will see that.
If you could collaborate with any artist, who would it be?
Russ? I don't even know. I'd probably Kanye or someone else.
If you could open a show for any artist, who would it be?
Russ.
Russ,
I'm gonna say Vince Staples.
I'm gonna say this nigga DeVito. To be honest, I'm talking about international.
How would you describe the music you typically make?
I'm describing like I'm mostly based on these kind of love music. You know what I'm saying? It's just to portray, like, to tell people. It's not about my love story, it's about what I'm basing, you know what I'm saying? My boys, I basically do music about love and shit, because I don't go with it, gang stuff, none of that shit. I don't do that. I'll talk about real life. It's about real life. It's about talking about females. To just give the females to know they're important in the world, you know what I'm saying? To let the females know, yeah, you guys are important. You guys are now just the kind of person. Love you guys, and we appreciate you guys, because ladies are like our mothers. You should take them like our mothers, and they're like a queen. You gotta treat them right, you know what I'm saying? So that's what I do.
I'm doing everything I can on my end. So, yeah, Layla, let's get it to number one. Let's go. Go stream it right now. If you're on here, go stream Yummy. Like, please. Because I really want this freaking spot.
How do you feel the internet has impacted the music industry?
I feel that it's impacted the music industry in a very positive way, because many rappers come up through the internet. Before, rappers had to try to break into the industry and sell mixtapes on the street and try to get people to listen. But now you have all these people who are getting famous off of SoundCloud. Like, I'm gonna bring Russ up again, but he was a SoundCloud rapper, and now he's one of the biggest in the world just from the internet. So I think the internet is a good resource. Also, Polo G came up through the internet. All of these new rappers are all coming up through the internet. And I think that's a really good thing.
Back to my point of how artists don't necessarily need substance to make music today. So right now with the internet, there's more access to people who are not very good at rap. So back then, like, you think, oh damn, the peak of rap and hip hop was like in the 90s, where we had Tupac, Wu-Tang, you know, all that other people.
The internet had a great opportunity to the music industry, because those fast people, the fast artists, you know what I'm saying, they don't have no internet and shit. You drop this song and they don't have nowhere to post it, you know what I'm saying? Like, people just get the views. Like, I wasn't born those days, but I don't know how to do it, but it's like kind of lucky and shit. But now these days, you know what I'm saying, modern day, when you drop a song, you go on Instagram, you post it, you send it, like, tap on the link on my bio and stuff, and you start getting it used. So I feel like the internet, like, impact a lot in the music industry right now. Like, it's really, really good. Like, 100% impact in the music industry, and it's really helping, like, new artists in the game right now. Also, artists already in the game before, so I think the internet is helping them really good. Now that we're online.
Beach. What's your favorite quote by an artist?
This bar's from Joey Badass. He was like, super bad chicks all up in my crib tonight. Super bad chicks and they all up in my crib tonight. Yeah, super bad chicks all up in my crib tonight. And kryptonite and super. Oh. Then he like used Superman and kryptonite, but he said crib tonight.
Oh,
Jesus. Tough.
DeVito, he dropped a song called Assurance. So it feels like this, you go like this, I give my baby assurance, I give my baby lifetime insurance.
I give my baby assurance, I give my baby lifetime insurance.
So that quote was like kind of crazy. I really love that part. Like, that part really makes sense, because it means, like, you really care about the girl you're dating, and you can do anything for the girl. Like, I really love that part so much, because that song, I still listen to that song every damn time. And that song is one of my favorite songs. Like, maybe not ever, like, instruction or all that shit. I really love that song, and I really love that part over that song.
If you could change anything about the music industry, what would it be?
I think the way that artists are treated, because many artists aren't getting paid as much as they should. Like NBA YoungBoy, he's currently in a contract that he wants out of, but because the industry is greedy, they're not letting him out of his contract, even though he's way bigger than he was when he first got into the industry. So he should be getting more money, but he's still getting how much he was getting before.
Maybe make it that rappers don't have to, like, they don't have to make a persona just to, you know, just to be relevant. Like, so I don't have to buy this 200K chain just to show you guys I'm balling, you know? I don't have to drive this car just to show you that I got it. Missing
it, man. I think about these kind of, to be honest, like the music video about the gun use and shit in the music videos, it's not necessary, to be honest. I'm not gonna lie to you. Or because I'm an Afrobeat artist and now like the rap, not into that rap stuff. But to be honest, I don't think we need a gun in the music video because that's not necessary. You know what I'm saying? The music video is supposed to be something you're having fun with. You don't need a gun in the music video. We just need to dress up, do whatever you want to do. We don't need that gun shit because that don't really mean anything to me, to be honest. I don't really need all that. And I'm not saying you can't use a gun, but it's like, it's not necessary.
If I could change anything about the music industry, it would be the over-sexualization of everything. Like, everything doesn't have to be over-sexualized. Like, they're going way too much into details now. Like, I get it. You want to put a few lines about that type of stuff here and there, but like, right now, the music that are being made right now, it's overboard. It's just way too much explicit things being said. Music is supposed to be about how you feel. It's supposed to make you happy, sad, comfort you in your times of need. Music brings people together, and that doesn't help it. That's it.
Biggie, bang, bang. Biggie, biggie. Heavy, heavy. Heavy, woman.